Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at aromatic reactions. So we're going to say, although benzene rings have pi bonds, just like alkenes and alkynes, they do not undergo addition reactions. That's because benzene rings are too stable. They belong to a class of compounds called aromatic compounds. And aromatic compounds don't want to do addition reactions. Now we're going to say, instead of doing addition reaction, benzene rings, as well as other aromatic compounds, will instead do a substitution reaction in order to maintain their aromaticity. Now we're going to say that the two major types of substitution reactions you're expected to know right now, the first one being halogenation. So basically, in halogenation, we're placing a halogen on benzene. But really, we're not just placing it on benzene, we're switching out an H on benzene for one of the halogens. So they're basically swapping. And we're going to say, in order to do this, we have to use what's called a Lewis acid catalyst. So these two things are Lewis acid catalysts. And remember, we've talked about Lewis acids before. Lewis acids are electron pair acceptors. The central element has less than 8 electrons around it, so it can accept additional reaction electrons. And these Lewis acid catalysts help this process occur. Now you'll notice here that we're doing Br2 and Cl2. So when we say halogenation, we're talking about bromination and chlorination. So we're talking about Br2 and Cl2. Also notice that our Lewis acid catalysts, here we're using Br, so the Lewis acid catalyst has Br. Here we're using Cl, so the Lewis acid catalyst also has Cl. They have to match each other. Now in this reaction, all that happens is one of the hydrogens anywhere on benzene switches places with the Br. So what we get here and here, we can draw the double bonds any way we want, because remember, we've talked about that as well, resonance and benzene. So both would be technically the same thing. Okay, so here we're just substituting in the halogen for the hydrogen. They got swapped. So what we just made here is bromo benzene. Here, if we did Cl, it'd be the same exact thing. And it could be any hydrogen anywhere on benzene that I'm switching with the Cl. So I decided to do the top one, but I could have done it anywhere. And there goes the Cl up here. And what did I make here? I made chlorobenzene. So chlorobenzene would be my answer. Now, that's all it is. So we're substituting in a halogen, in this case Br or Cl. Look at how the Lewis acid catalyst is matched. You use Br2, so you have to use FeBr3. You use Cl2, so you have to use FeCl3. Now, the other major type of reaction you're expected to know, here, this is called Friedel-Crafts alkylation. I know, it's a mouthful. So here, this is where an alkyl group is placed on benzene. So an alkyl group switches places with a hydrogen. And notice here, we're also using a Lewis acid catalyst. Here, this Lewis acid catalyst is not Fe anymore, it's aluminum here in the center. And notice, see how this is a Cl? So this is a Cl, meaning that if that was a Br, it would be AlBr3. All that happens in this reaction is that the H and the alkyl substituent or alkyl group, they switch, they swap. So we get now, we're going to get this structure here. So there goes a CH3 on benzene. So we can say that this is called methyl benzene. That's its scientific name. But there's also a very common name for it as well. Or toluene. When you have a methyl on benzene, the common name is called toluene. Okay, so that's what happens here with halogenation and Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Now, there's more than just these benzene reactions. When you get to organic 2, you'll learn more about the other ones. There's sulfonation, nitration. There's a lot of different reactions that benzene can do. Here, we're just limited to these two. So, now that we've seen those two, let's see if you guys can attempt to do this example question here. So here, this is just another example of one of the two reactions we went over. Try to isolate the answer. Come back and see how I approach the question. Good luck, guys.